I was on the cover of Downbeat. I was a new and singular voice. I don't even know why I hang with you. I mean, you're a bar miss for playing, bebop, diddly squit squit squat, and diddly tit 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 toddling asshole. I mean, I don't play with some major cats. Sonny, Art, Diz. I'm on fucking records, man. I got a discography. What do you got?
I'm a music worker. You know, like, hey, Al, you want to do a wedding in Brooklyn? Or, hey, Al, Doc Severinsen's alto man's sick. He's opening tonight at the Plaza. If he likes it, six nights after that, who knows? Like that. I do jingles and demos. Classical, rock and roll, whatever else they need. I can play every reed instrument there is, plus flute and piccolo. I'm a professional New York sideman. Like that. Listen, not one of the late great, but I'll tell you something. You know all those big guys, Diz, Monk, Sonny, Train, Miles? I love them, man. Nobody loves or respects them more than I do. But if you take us away, us guys who are just excellent, we wouldn't have enough music to go around.
I had a dream about you.
Tell me.
Oh, you, me, Birdland Pee-wee.
Pee-wee?
That's the guy called him a half motherfucker.
What'd your dreams play? Me?
Can't remember.
It'll come. Got a shitload of work today, including a session at EUE.
No, they want real instruments?
Yeah, yeah. Client hates synthesizers.
Hey, it's refreshing.
Salami commercial. Which is gonna put us both in the mood and a location for the Carnegie.
Oh, I thought we swore off Delhi.
We did. Which is why we walk past the Carnegie and we go into Zelman's Natural Food.
Yeah. Vegetarian. Health.
First. Play.
Okay, guys, let's go. One, two, three.
Practice the major sevens, man.
Why? No, it's this guy's notes. I can't read his fucking...
Okay, guys. Let's try running once from the top without the vocals. One, two, two, three, four.
Say we give these guys 12 more hours tops to show up, and then we split. This is absolutely bullshit. Unprofessional.
This is nothing, man. I waited 10 days for the Eagles to show up. They never came. I took that money, bought myself a Corvette. Got us a wedding at the New York Palace.
Oh, great, great.
Come on. Change my place.
No, no, no. Oh. Is it tonight? I can't, man. I promised Janice I'd take her to the movies.
This is a double-scale date. It's in the Versailles room. I got the best food in the Versailles room.
Oh, wow.
Come on, we'll take a train.
No, no, no. Let's get a cab. Wait a minute. Who's booking this? Beamstrom?
Yes, Beamstrom is booking it. He's forgiven us. All right, me. He's forgiven me. He'll take you on as a favor to me.
Yeah? Fuck him. Fuck him. I don't want any favors from that creep. Absolutely not.
Yes, you do. Do you want to go on a cruise in Bermuda in January? You want weddings in June?
I called him a rat-faced motherfucker with his face. I mean...
Yeah, I know. I was there.
I told him he didn't know his asshole from an eighth note.
I was there.
Can I put you down for work tonight or what?
I guess so.
Okay.
How come I can't get a fucking cabin this day?
You hanging around with me?
You are the angel's glow that lights the star. The dearest things I know.
Of you, ladies and gentlemen, but have no fear. We shall return. In the meantime, I espy refreshments.
You espy refreshments? What the fuck is that?
Class, Al. A concept foreign to musicians.
I'll tell Pavarotti. I'm kidding.
Hey, how's Janice?
She's fine, huh?
Looking forward to Christmas in the Caribbean?
Yes, sir.
Listen, Al, you tell her everything's gonna be fine. You and I had a little spat, but he straightened it out, so here we are. Let bygones be bygones, right?
Put it there.
Like men, right?
Irv,
more than men.
Violation of the union rules for me to even be talking to you at this hour.
Look, we're willing to pay. I mean, you guys were so fucking fantastic, okay? I mean, we have just got to keep dancing.
Peep this. It's 2:15 in the morning. You are now into golden, platinum, beryllium overtime. Plus, you got unlawful contractor penalties, you got travel penalties, you got night fringes, you got no-show payments. We're talking $1,000 a man.
Fine.
Cool.
Okay, we're going to 216 Park, apartment B, okay? Now, is there anything you need at all? Anything, you name it, it's there for you.
I just need a pen. Now, we need some transport because I don't want none of the guys having to pay to go nowhere.
Oh, not a problem.
There's some food, too.
Not a problem, sure.
I'm talking sandwiches.
place. Who owns this fucking place?
I do. Are they missing me?
Musically? No. I wasn't talking about
musically. Wait a minute. When have you saved my ass musically? I can't think of one.
Yeah. All those twos you keep forgetting.
What?
Who's got to start you off?
Then what?
Then what?
Tune, you got to start me off. Buddy.
Aww.
No, really. That's outrageous.
All right. Sidewalks in New York. Yeah.
I know it's something else.
Sing it.
Sidewalks in New York?
Any key.
Buddy.
Ow.
Buddy.
Ow.
Start now.
Dun. Dun 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 dun.
I know.
Hi.
Let's see him.
Oh, where? I want.
Oh, baby.
Morning, Al.
Good morning.
How are you, Al? Did you work hard?
Yeah. We had a private gig afterwards. Reached me $1,000.
Wow, that's great, Al.
Yeah. Hey, let's have coffee. I'm by.
I'll be late for school now.
You're the assistant principal. Who's going to say anything?
The principal.
So, tonight, early dinner, you and me, romance to follow. You look beautiful.
Norman called. You have a Broadway gig tonight.
Tomorrow.
It's tonight.
Saturday. No weddings. We go to the country. We walk in the woods. Woodstock. What?
You forgot? We're going to Northport on Saturday, Al.
Business, the printing. Yeah, I forgot.
Yeah, of course you forgot.
Honey, is this something we really want to do? Straight gig? Join the middle class?
It's the upper class, Al. It's a business that makes $200,000 a year.
Yeah, but it's a business, and I'm a musician.
And me? What about me?
I want you to be happy.
I just want to check it out.
Honey, Saturday, we're checking it out. We're checking it out. Who's going to stop us? We'll take Buddy. We'll make a groovy day of it. We're checking it out. I love you, baby. You know why?
Al. You have lipstick on.
It's a wedding, honey. Everybody kissed the bride. It's a custom.
How about you?
Over a year now.
Wow. It's a year.
Yeah.
Hey, you want to have dinner after the show?
Oh, you know, I made plans with the... You remember Naomi?
Buddy's here. We'll all go.
5 minutes, everyone. 5 minutes.
I can't believe it's a year.
See.
Hey, so who told you to get a hit show? You like I'm doing weddings?
Jack, show him the music now. You can screw around later, please.
All right.
Anything tough?
No. It's just this one part right here.
Right.
Right here, you gotta wait for this cue, okay? Right. Now, that comes from me, not our conductor, Norman. And I get that off the stage because Norman has been over the damn brass too far. He's making love.
Shitting me.
No, I'm not. You'll see. One night, he fell off.
You're shitting.
Oh, wait, and this.
All right.
Flat.
I get it.
No, that's it. You got it.
Hey, guys, come on. The show is starting.
Right. Yeah.
That's Broadway, baby.
Yeah, on Mother's stage. All right.
Hey, everything okay?
Oh, yeah. All right.
Hey, Jack, Bernie should get sick more often. I like this guy. He plays good.
Hey, thanks, man.
Maybe I should have him killed.
Oh, wow. Come on, that's cold-blooded, bro.
No musician. Gee.
No, he's not. He's a crossword puzzle freak. I look down, he's not playing, he's doing a puzzle. The saxes sound thin because this putz is thinking five letters, a river in Africa or something. You want this job?
Serious?
Yeah.
Playing the same music every night? I don't know if I could do that.
No. Who says you have to? Bernie doesn't.
I heard you good a couple of times.
Do it. Good. Oh, man, doing that night after night.
No. So, where do we dine?
Joe Allen's.
One show and you turn it to Mr. Broadway.
That's right.
Want a surprise? Watch this.
Huh?
No. Surprise.
Hey, everybody.
Hey.
Sarah, of course. And Naomi.
Hi.
Oh, what's Boris about today? That's it.
Dance a long time.
For about 10 years. I'm way in the back now, though.
No, I saw you. Like, you were like one of the best ones, really.
Would you like me to come home with you?
That's not much of an idea.
I'm not much of a thinker. Oh, she's so beautiful. You know what? I'm glad she said no. I don't want to start it ever again.
She didn't say no. She said, I don't think it's a good idea.
Same thing. She's right.
You don't mean it.
Hey, if I spent half the energy on my marriage that I spent chasing that chick around, my wife would be so happy she'd kill for me.
You don't mean it.
Listen, at this point, I don't even have the chops. I'm just like on automatic pilot. I'd see her, I'd get crazy, but it'd be temporary. It's true.
We'll see.
And so anyway, the subs are just getting worse and worse. You know, they come in and they expect to just babysit for the whole period. Oh, God, I had such a creep yesterday. How did they get licensed? Are you listening to me, Al?
Uh-huh.
Well, I wish you'd acknowledge my presence once in a while, Al. Just, you know, even a grunt would do.
I do grunt. I grunt soft.
You didn't grunt, Al.
Honey, I did. I grunted.
What is this? Is this about going out to Northport? Because it's something that we agreed to do,
Al.
Yeah,
to check it out, not to do it.
All right, well, what else?
Nothing.
Are you having personal problems?
Don't be crazy, baby.
I'm not crazy, Al. I just...
Perfect timing, guys. Hey. I got that picnic basket.
Yeah.
All
right. This is my husband, Al. Al, this is Howard.
Hi, Al. The town grows, we grow. And let me tell you something. The town is growing. And talk about franchise support. These people are nothing short of fantastic. You know, it's like being in a family. A big, happy family. Al, you hear that noise? Every click on the machine represents a penny and a half.
Got a bathroom?
Over there. Well, let me show you support.
Buddy, what would you say, B flat?
Hey, sure.
So it's an hour by train from the city, and we live in a house. I get my garden. There's no crime.
You need a water? You don't have to kiss Beanstrom's ass for a cruise?
Hey, I'm not good at that shit. I don't have a head for business, man. Don't you understand? You think I could figure out how to put a smoke alarm in a toilet, for Christ's sakes? You know that's a violation of the First Amendment, don't you? And look at this. Show this to your lawyer. Show this to your accountant. I don't have a lawyer. I don't have an accountant. I have a dentist, a doctor, a bookie, a dealer. I don't have a lawyer.
Okay, honey.
I don't have a frigging accountant, for Christ's sake. You know what? This is like Russia. This is just like Russia, the way it used to be, where you used to have to do what the government told you to, and you didn't even have a choice. Comrade, you will work in a Pepsi, and you'll be happy. But comrade says, I groove on that saxophone ski. Man, I bend and bob with the Downcats on 52nd Street. The life of a Pepsi, it's not for me. Believe what I'm laying down.
Sorry, man, but from now on, it's how many copies? How many copies?
That's what it's like. Can't dig that, man? It's not me.
52nd Street, huh?
You know what I'm talking about. I mean, I played with guys that played with Charlie Parker.
Big deal. I mean, the number of guys that said he played with Charlie Parker is around 45,000.
What's that have to do with anything, buddy?
It's a very big
No.
You want a big number, buddy? This guy nets $200,000 a year.
Can you believe me?
Well, it looked busy, didn't it?
I'll tell you a story about my grandfather. He was a blacksmith. Learned his trade from his daddy in Alabama. Moves up north to the land of plenty. Saves and saves and saves. He's about this blacksmith shop in Cornwall, Connecticut. So he goes up there. Business is booming. I mean, the people are lined up. There's horses to be shoed. There's tools to be repaired. So he plunks down his life savings. It was my grandmother and their five kids up from Alabama. They move into a house. September. They spend a year there, and they can't make a dime. Not a dime. They almost starve through the winter. I mean, the neighbors have got to come and help them out. He gives up, moves back to New York. 50 years later, I'm there. I meet this guy. He tells me the story about this blacksmith shop owner who, it's all of his friends to come there and act like the place is busy. How are you? I checked the books.
Ladies and gentlemen, as you know, we have something special down here for you at Bird Line. For you at
the
Bird
Line. Artistry, artistry of Clifford Brown.
Hey, aren't you gonna kiss me goodbye?
No, I'm not. If I kiss you goodbye, one thing's gonna lead to another.
Come here.
You had your chance between 3 and 7 a.m.
I did?
Those were my horny hours. Do you remember that? Mm. That's what you said you liked about me when we met. Are you working tonight?
Why did you go to class?
There's a Truffaut double feature at the Waverly, if you're into heavy memories. Mm. Otherwise, it would be me, dinner, and a second chance.
Oh, honey, I'm all yours.
All right. Go back to sleep. Goodbye.
Goodbye, honey.
You want to come hear me play the blue note tonight?
Oh, man, I just got a swing dance. It goes till around 9.
That's cool. Come to the last set, all right?
Yeah, tell Mrs. Gorky that I can't meet her at the Waverly because I've got to play work. For me, it's the same thing. No, not basketball. Just tell her, okay? Thank you. Bye.
Headaches. The upper registers are bothering me these days.
Wow, you and Buddy Bolden.
Yeah.
Wow. Been to a doctor?
Yeah.
What are you saying?
You know what they all say. Told me to go see another doctor. Tuesday. You want to come?
Oh, sure. A hint?
Well, you can't wait. I mean, we're going inside. Hey, is that your watch?
Mr. Man.
Well, let's go inside. This is gonna blow you away. From a friend.
I see.
You remember me?
Trumpet.
It's amazing. Let's see. Do you mind?
Not at all.
What do you say?
It's a person.
What else?
It's got character. Balance, age, you tell me.
Clifford Brown. There was Clifford Browns. And they're spectacular.
How do you know that?
It disappeared from the estate. It just wound up here, right?
Wow.
See?
ground.
Buddy, that's what's playing Birdland in my dream.
It all comes together now.
Play.
Buddy, you gotta own that horn.
It's $2,500.
Some things never change.
No. You're looking at a serious potential, uncommitted but leaning buyer. I love that horn.
No, don't know anything yet. You're gonna have to wait for me. Okay, Janice. All right. Oh, look at that. No, tell Eric.
Janet says hi.
Yes.
She's fine. How are you? What the doctor say?
Oh, man. I mean, I'm getting these headaches. I'm taking these pills. I'm mistaking lions for tigers. I'm thinking lion, but I'm saying tiger. I get up and go somewhere. I don't remember where I'm going. I mean, you know, the doctor says it's cool. He says for me not to worry about anything. He says, just take some tests and everything's gonna be cool. We play tonight?
No, Monday. Nell's.
Good.
Yeah. All right. Wanna get up? Let's get out of here.
Yeah.
Great tonight, buddy. Just great.
Thanks, man. She wants me to go on tour with her.
A lot of good music, man. Good money.
I just get into trouble like always. Let me tell you about that orgy in Brussels.
Mm-hmm. See, Janice, it's stuff like this that keeps the marriage fresh.
Al, don't talk. Conserve your energy.
Hey, Buddy and I are playing at Nell's tomorrow. You want to come? Sing with us.
It's a school night.
I know, but you get 2 songs per set, and I'll play my ass off for you.
And we'll eat afterwards.
And I'll stay awake in bed. And I'll play on you until you have to go to work in the morning. At practice. Yeah.
Then I'll fall asleep at my desk and... I have to talk to kids who got busted for falling asleep at their desk.
Maybe. Maybe.
It'll be like old times.
That's right, baby.
I'm old-fashioned, I love I love the old-fashioned things. The sound of rain upon a window pane. The starry song that April sings. This year's fancies are passing fancies, but sighing sighs, holding hands, these my heart understands. I'm old fashioned, but I don't mind it. That's how I want to be, as long as you agree to stay old-fashioned with me. I'm gonna die if I don't get some sleep.
No, you.
No.
We're on 30 minutes.
Oh,
two
no.
more sets.
No, I can't do that. I can't.
One more song.
Let her go, man. She's an educator.
I don't want to fall in love with this again. I gotta go.
I guess you can.
Okay.
Yeah. Night. You sang great.
Okay. You played good tonight.
Thanks. Go get something to eat later.
Oh, no.
Yes, indeed.
Yes, crazy. I feel like Chinese.
Say hello.
You sure?
Sure.
Well, hello. Wow, you look very beautiful. Well, is this a coincidence? Or?
His idea.
Oh.
I forgot how much I love the way you play.
That's how we got started, don't you remember?
Oh, yeah. I remember.
Mm-hmm. I'll call you tomorrow.
You're just gonna talk me into something I already wanna do, and then we're just gonna end up talking ourselves out of it.
Baby, I'm just being friendly.
Not too early.
Never early. Bye. Bye.
Hey. Who's the singer?
Wasn't she great?
Get some to eat. Am I crazy? I feel like Chinese.
Are you okay?
What, I don't look okay?
You look fine. How do you feel?
Feel? What's the question?
I said, how do you feel?
I feel fine. I feel fine. You should get on out of here.
Gotta be a big machine. Don't worry, man. I'll be there. Love you.
Tell him.
The tumor shows up in both the X-rays.
Tell him how long.
What?
There can be a rapid increase.
3 months.
What do you mean 3 months?
3 months, maybe.
That's the most negative prognosis. There is a possibility.
All right, four. I'm happy.
Let her finish. Let her finish.
It's finished.
No, we're going to hear about beating it, about new cures, experimental drugs. Doctor, go, go, gimme. What? Ah, oh, for Christ's sake.
Got a good pal.
Well, we certainly get a second opinion.
She has a second opinion.
Doctor? Okay. No. Thank you. If you want to come up, Jim Chesty, be.
No.
I gotta get up early in the morning and start looking for quacks.
Quacks? Come on, run.
Now you're losing your sense of humor. I mean, what am I gonna do in these last few days of my life if you start getting bored on me?
Buddy.
Al. You know what today is? Today is the worst. Because today I found out. Now I know. Fuck! Now it's gonna... It's gonna get better. My life is gonna be better. Okay? Let's go home, Al. Let's go home.
What is it?
Oh. It's Buddy. He's got a brain tumor. And it's malignant. And he's dying.
Did you see the doc?
Yeah, like Marco Polo to the Great Khan. We spoke of invisible rays, extraordinary drugs. And am I gonna lose my lip along with my hair?
What'd she say?
She said I can play up to the very end. She said that I can play at my own funeral, you know, one last note, and I'll just hop into the coffin.
Hey, that ain't happening, man.
Yes, it is.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
I don't want to hear that. We're fighting this. We're checking out more doctors. We're not giving up. We're fighting it.
Oh. No. It's a very beautiful speech. It's a definite call to action. But we are not going to more doctors. We are not fighting this. We do not have this. I have it. It's mine. It's in my body. And I'm the one that decides what happens to it. I'm not giving it to you, okay? You can't borrow it. It's mine. That's it.
So there.
You and Al are going to be a great comfort to me in these last days of my life. You know some of mine?
What, you're not happy for Chinese?
No, I'm not happy with the Chinese.
Oh. Well, then I don't know what's on your mind.
Come. Let's have a party.
Yeah?
Big one. You know? We invite all the cats up north and the ladies. And we play. We drink. We play. That's what I want, Al. Good music. And we have grass and people and lots of locks. Lots of locks. Right? Okay. I got life insurance.
Yeah.
Okay, so you front the money. I die. You get it back.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we could spend thousands on this party. You choose the place, I choose the food, and we play. You and me, the Cherokee.
Cherokee.
Yeah. What are we doing tomorrow?
Working.
Okay, so we start getting ready the day after tomorrow. All right? Have a party, man. Buddy, this is gonna be great. I mean, you eat. You know, I'm not hungry. I gotta get some sleep. I mean, because you have got to get ready for this, because this is big. This is big. This is big. This is bigger than big. This is, you know, music and food and women. Music and food and grass and locks and locks and locks. Lots of locks, Al. Lots of locks, man. Right now, Dr. Cooper says it's about the size of my right nut. But it's getting bigger. So I'm looking forward because there's only so much room in my skull for one terrific headache and some extras. All in the category of loss, you know, like loss of sight, loss of hearing, so on, so forth.
What are you saying?
I'm saying it's gonna hurt like a motherfucker. That's what I'm saying. And if that's not enough to piss me off, I'm also gonna be deaf, dumb, and blind.
What are you saying?
I'm saying I'm scared. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking of taking steps to avoid the condition. I mean, if I can't play, if I can't think, that ain't me.
Steps?
Pills. Got a stash of pills. You feel like a movie?
Are you putting me on?
No. I'm going to a movie.
Buddy.
I'm going to the movie. Want to come?
Are you putting me on? You're late.
Boccherini's tenor saxophone concerto.
I don't know it.
It's easy. It's all in G. I'll start you off.
I don't know it.
Then we'll play Cherokee.
I'm not ready.
I'm not ready, man.
body. I'm not ready.
I'm not ready.
I'm not ready.
Hey, I'm not ready.
I'm not ready.
I'm not ready, man.
I'm not ready.
I'm not ready.
I'm not ready.
I'm not ready.
Buddy, please.
I'm not ready.
I'm not ready.
I'm not ready.
I'm not ready.
I'm not ready, man.
I'm not ready.
I'm not ready.
I'm not ready.
I'm not ready.
Listen to me. I've been thinking about this. And tonight, too. I know this is my teacher's voice, and I'm sorry, but the printing store deal is possible now. It's real, Al. We have enough for a down payment.
It's not the time now.
Yes, it is. It is, Al. And we can get the rest of the money from my father. My father will lend us the money.
He wants a big party. Say goodbye. Like afterwards, he's gonna check out. He's got pills, that's what he says.
Oh, good
God. So it's nap time now.
Where are you going? Al?
Remember, buddy.
Which one was he?
Trumpet player.
Oh, mm-hmm.
By the way, this is just a beautiful apartment.
Thank you.
Do you think I could borrow it for one night?
Really has to be in the next month? I just hate it that I'm gonna miss your party.
I could make it up to you.
When?
Right now, if you want.
Right now?
Right here and now.
Here?
Mm-hmm.
I think I'd rather go upstairs.
What's his name?
Who?
You know, the painter, the blue, the white, the boats.
Dufy.
Hey, I got his place for the party on Park Avenue.
Park? I'm gonna have a party on Park? Oh, you did it, my friend. Oh.
I'll take it.
Sir?
The trumpet, the Clifford Brown trumpet.
Sold it.
Who?
Doctor. Or his kid.
Could I have his number, please?
And I'd like to talk to you about the trumpet that you bought for your son. So if you could please call me as soon as possible at 555-3692. And have me beeped. I'd appreciate it. Again, that's 555-3692. Thank you very much, Doc.
I went down to that pawn shop and sold that trumpet.
Living in the country? Huh? Dig this, Janice. Friendly native. Good man.
You remember Square, Al? People used to be square.
Yeah.
But we were hip.
Our baby. We're still hip.
Why is that? Is that because we like jazz and art and we live in the village?
That's right. Because we know bullshit when we see it. We're freer,
and more tolerant. We're hip. We're hip. What can I say? You know, just because we're getting old, we don't put stuff down. And we're funny. We do riffs. We're happy. We know how to be happy. And, you know, we still got good taste. We're hip, honey. What can I say? We're hip.
Then how come I'm not happy?
This is about the printing business.
Al, you and I need some time apart. That's not right. I want some time apart from you, Al. I'm going to stay up here for a couple of days. And I'm going to give you a chance to move in with Buddy or whatever.
Wait, Al,
this isn't an argument. This is a decision, and it isn't sudden. This is just the time for it.
Now?
Are you kidding? No, I'm not.
This is the time when I need you more than ever. You can't do this now. You can't do this now. Jesus, Janice, we got to talk about this. Not now.
It's not something that I'm doing, Al. It's just something that's happening.
Are these delightful? Oh, what? I could chew a cherry pie. I could chew a hamburger. And for me, the Royal Order of the French Fry, because I'm that kind of guy. I should never shop for jewelry when I'm hungry. Okay. Is it something I did? I mean, is it something that I said?
Domestic dispute.
It's nothing, buddy. Come on, I'm starving.
I can't believe I said something I did. That's the way chicks are, man. They're more comfortable with bad news and strange surroundings. My first wife, Lana, she was like that.
Not my favorite.
We were young. We were stupid. And when we took this trip to Mexico, little resort, you know how long and how far that is from me?
I only know by cruise ship.
Fuck cruise ships. We're talking planes. Talking luggage. Tourist cards, suntan oil. So we get there, we unpack, hit the beach. I lie down, she looks at me, says, I want a divorce. This marriage is over.
I'm saying, you couldn't tell me this before we left New York? I mean, we're here now. I mean, you see how hard it was for us to get here. Just think how hard it's gonna be for us to get out. 3 days, I'm waiting for a plane. 3 days, I'm stuck in a hotel room with a woman who's trying to tell me how I ruined her life.
Yeah. Yeah, this time I think she really means it.
You know that?
I was like, I feel, bad. You know, like I, never knew her. Like I've lived my life without her, and I'm somehow looking back, and somebody taps me on the shoulder and says, hey, you know what's wrong with your life? You never met Janice. Wow. How's that possible? I mean, how can I even feel that? Even possible?
It's easy. You're confusing reality, reality.
Oh, see, I knew you were gonna help me out on that.
Look, it's like this. You got two realities. One says, Al, you're not happy. The other says you are.
Do you know the story about a guy who goes on his honeymoon? Big hotel. He's sitting by the pool one day, and he looks over. And he sees this great-looking babe in a white bathing suit just for a second passing by. And for the next 20 years of his life, he's haunted by this image. Mysterious, briefly glimpsed obsession. I mean, she's always standing in between him and his wife. I mean, he can never really love his wife. Because of this woman. So 20 years later,
He goes back to the same hotel. It's his anniversary. He's sitting by the pool. Looks up. And he sees her. Same white bathing suit. But this time, he gets up. He runs over to her. He grabs her. Turns her around. Looks her in the eyes. And it's his wife.
It's me.
Yeah. It's Twilight Zone.
Oh.
You're gonna be all right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sonny Rollins told me once, he said he didn't like going on the road because it interfered with his practice.
Wow. Hey, there's a guy in Germany.
No, there isn't.
Buddy, we can try.
No, we can try to live a good life until we die. I.
And there's a guy in Germany.
No, there isn't.
He freezes you, then he brings you back.
I think I'm fine, just the way I am. Thank you.
Yeah.
This. My hand, like.
Because of chicks, it'll be because of music. And I got used to it, Al. I didn't mind. Because you'd come home and we'd make love and we'd talk. You'd tell me about the music. You'd sing solos in my ear. Now you come home and you just try not to wake me up. There's no music, Al. So it must be chicks. Fuck you, everybody. Kiss the bride.
Story. 90% of the people we want to invite are musicians. They work parties. They don't go to parties.
Then tell them to celebrate our friendship.
What do they care?
They tell them something else.
Benny, how you doing?
You want to hear complaints?
No, thanks. Listen, I'm putting together a band on the 16th.
My back is killing me.
It's a private party.
Not to mention my kid is bugging me for a car.
Do you want the job?
Since when are you booking gigs?
Since now. Yes? No?
Yes, yes.
Great. And keep it quiet. I don't want to hurt anybody's feelings.
Don't worry. You got it.
216 Park Avenue.
Part B.
Harry! Harry!
Yo!
Hey!
Harry!
I was just gonna call you. I need you on the 16th.
Who doesn't? I'm in demand.
Hey, don't be a puss. It's a private party. Cat loves jazz.
Oh, man, I'm busy.
Double scale.
I'll be there.
Okay, it's 216 Park Avenue, Part B.
Okay.
And if you want, you can bring your wife.
Wife?
He's a nice guy. He wants the players to be happy. Okay, don't bring your wife.
Hello!
Great food, great music, great women.
Oh, great.
Fancy gig. I mean, that's gonna be better. You wanna do wedding crap or a couple of your own shows?
Look, don't bust my balls, okay?
No, they asked for you. And it's triple skin. And you can bring it in.
A date. What the hell kind of gig do they ask you to bring a date?
Okay, Buster, what's going on around here? I got a major wedding at the Carlisle, and all of a sudden, my best ain't available. So?
I don't know anything about it, Irv. Surely they're good guys willing to play their asses off for you.
So where are they? And here's what else I hear. Your booking a gig is the reason why.
Not true.
I want you and Buddy playing for me on the 16th at the Carlisle, or you never work again. No more cruises, no gigs from me. And what's more, I badmouth you. I call in every marker I can think of. Your phone will not ring off the hook. Believe me.
I saw you through the window. Make us some tea.
I'm not coming to your fucking party if you're gonna kill yourself.
Please, just make some tea.
I don't want tea. I want vodka.
How's been working his ass off?
Yeah, I hear.
He's been practicing.
What's gotten into him?
Well, I think he's taking his music a bit more seriously. It's character building. Here. So, when do you plan to take him back?
When his character's all built, I guess.
That's good, Nick. I mean, the boy is showing excellent energy, stamina, and wisdom ain't far behind that. Besides, he really loves you. He really does. You to remember me that way. And if there's an after for me, not for me to remember you remembering me that way. Um,
you are. Are you hungry?
No, I'm fine. But how about you? We could go out.
No. I like it here.
Hey, do you remember that night in front of the five spot?
Remembering's not my strong point these days.
Al and I had that big fight because he was flirting all night with that singer, that April. And you told him if he didn't stop being such an asshole that you were going to fall in love with me and you were going to take me home and he wouldn't even get visiting privileges. Remember?
No, I don't remember that.
Buddy.
Yes? I do remember one thing between me and you.
You do?
Mm-hmm. We were taking a swim.
Yeah.
A plunge into the big deep.
In Woodstock.
Yeah. Woodstock. And we were changing our clothes behind this tree. And your tree was so thin.
Oh, my God.
I got a glimpse. I got a little look. I got a little present of your breast that day.
You remember that?
It's one of the most beautiful memories of my life. That summer in Woodstock. I remember thinking, you're so beautiful today. If we could. If you and I. It's not about sex, you know? Interesting that these days. It's you. I love you so much. So I never knew they could do so many things with pigeons.
Oh,
you
know? A very versatile bird.
All right, so we should have them three ways then. We should have them roasted with raisins.
Mm.
We should have them braised with fennel.
Mm.
And for good luck and an odd duty Chinese, steamed with lettuce and ginger.
Why not?
You know, today I learned what a scruple is. It's from the Greek, meaning a pebble in one's sandal. Well, free walking, light stepping, nimble toed, elegant man. I'm free walking, light stepping, nimble toed, elegant man. Free walking, light stepping, nimble toed. Something, isn't it? We get a good deal on locks?
Yeah.
And a bistro?
I'm working on it. Do you want me to invite Jeannie?
I
got her
so.
Number.
Mm-mm. I mean, I only want chicks that I'm cool with. I don't want no angry people. And I don't want no cries. I don't want nobody looking at me with no wet eyes. You know, just in case the word gets out.
How's the word gonna get out? You, me, and Janice are the only ones that know, unless you, told somebody.
No, I didn't. But we have big mouths, don't we?
Yeah. Okay, so just in case then, no crying.
That's gonna leave that long, eh? Yeah. I said to him once, how you doing, Long Eddie? He says, I'm doing so bad. I wanna go buy a gun and shoot myself. I said, Long Eddie, you want some advice? Don't buy. Rent. Look, you shouldn't buy Beanstrom. Yeah, give me the last time I see him.
Just tell him it's Al Gorky about the trumpet. 555-3692. Thanks.
Irving. Irv, I just feel terrible about all this confusion.
Just terrible.
Why didn't you tell me?
Hey, come on. Would you have wanted me to blow the surprise birthday party of the year before it was even set?
You think for a moment I'm going to tell anything that I shouldn't be telling?
Oh, Irving.
You were really going to invite me?
Irving, there's no party without you.
Well, that's an entirely different situation. I'll subcontract a Carlisle gig.
I'll tell you one thing, we got one hell of a brass section.
Signing in.
Sign it.
What the hell kind of gig is this they want you to sign in?
Lester, just sign it.
Ladies and gentlemen, There is no gig. What there is instead is a gift. From somebody who's just had a death in the family, leaving him an entire fortune. So money doesn't mean shit to him, but your friendship and love and music over the years do. I'm speaking of that all-around beautiful cat, Buddy Chester.
Dude. Now, so this is what we're gonna do. Okay, we're just gonna party, all right? We got the whole place. We can dance, we can eat, we can drink, we can play.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Chickens are a little small.
That's not chickens, pigeon.
Pigeon? Who eats pigeons? You said all these beautiful days.
I said the best thing, not the worst thing, is that it could never happen again.
Ooh, you always was a mean talker, but a meaner player. Get up there and do your thing.
lots. Irv, save some for the rest.
It's authentic Scotch salmon. I can't control myself.
Good thing you're playing, man. We're gonna play something late, I'm telling you.
Definitely.
Your wife. She's on the phone.
Didn't you hear me? He's busy.
It's about the trumpet.
Janice. I'll be down in a minute.
Where is it?
It's playing at a high school dance in Brooklyn.
Sell it. He won't lend it. I said he can come play with us. I named the guys.
Yeah.
He never heard of us.
Well, it's getting late, Al.
Right? I'm sorry. Have you guys met?
Yes, before.
Yeah. You were gone?
Yeah, secret mission. You're man.
It was a surprise, right?
Yeah.
I got Clifford Brown's horn. What are we gonna play?
Cherokee.
Okay. I'll play Cherokee. You ready for that?
I'm ready for that. Right. Cherokee?
One, two, three.
Thank you.
Who knew? Maybe I'll cut your mouthpiece, you know what?
Do you know Big Moment?
Yeah.
Big Moment? One, two, three.
Nice party, guys. Very nice party. Buddy, I'm here to say my goodbyes. Have a wonderful time.
You going somewhere?
Hey, keep a secret from me. Don't be silly. I knew this is really a farewell party. I'm gonna miss you, buddy.
Thanks, man.
Listen, I wish I could go with you.
Irv, a lot of guys wish that, too.
I still don't know what kind of gig that was, but I liked it.
Hala wishes. Beautiful party. Beautiful, hey. Buddy.
Hey, man.
Good looking out. Thanks.
No.
I cannot take this paper.
Get out of here, man. It's for you.
I feel like I'm stealing. Take this.
No, man. It's for you.
All right, I'll take it. Thanks,
man. So you're gonna be able to get home?
Yeah, I'm cool. Okay.
So that horn, it really belonged to Clifford Brown, huh? You know, I dug playing with you guys.
I dug playing with you.
No, I mean, if anything like this should ever come up again, you know, I'm ready.
You're ready.
Thanks. Antidote, Ray.
Ozone?
Yeah, Pozo. You remember?
Yeah. Remember the time he was looking at you like, you know, in a way, and I said, how come he's looking at you like that? And you said,
I said,
you said, because he saw me on the cover of Downbeat.
Yeah. Man.
You're all out. You got nothing more for me?
I don't think so, man. Well, I gave you the best I got. You know that.
I want more.
What else can I give you?
Dana's phone number.
I don't have the number.
No. No more phone numbers.
No more phone numbers.
Mm.
Great.
I don't know. Really?
You know, besides music, man, you're the best thing in my life. It's like this. We're in this cab. We're highest kites. We're going downtown. Music's still pumping and blasting in our heads. Cherokee, right?
Mm.
And I say to the driver, first stop, 75th, then go to the village. It's just like always, man. It's just like always.
going downtown, and I get off first. Play beautiful tonight.
Yeah, I've been practicing.
I'm gonna tell you what Sonny Rollins said to me. He said, I don't like to go on the road, because it interferes with my practicing.
Why, he said that to you?
Like I need somebody to tell me to practice.
You know me, I always miss the best part.
You are the best part.
I'm so happy you came home.
I want you to play something for me.
Is this request night?
No, she wants.
You
play anything you want.
Okay, for lovely jazz from
Midwood High.
Branch Village.
New York City.
And for all those cats who love this woman, yes. Some more than others, like Buddy Chester. Yes.
Play.
Up jumps.
Oh. Yes.
This dream, you were dead.
Get out of here.
Yeah. We had this big party, and everybody came, and we drank champagne, and ate great, and you and me, we played Cherokee and Sunny Moon, Up Jump Spring.
You and me, Cherokee.
Yeah, beautiful, like we never played before.
And was the chicks there?
Yeah, all over you. All over you.
And fool.
Yeah, like only the finest. Italian, Chinese, fancy French.
Who paid for this party?
You did?
You're fucking right, you're dreaming.
So you're not dead?
Of course I'm dead. I'm just not paying for the party. That's all.